Hey guys, welcome you all again. In this video we will know if this phone is still worthwhile in 2020. So let us compare this phone with latest releases like M51 and Realme 7. Let's see a brief of unboxing. So this is the box I received via Flipkart. So I will remove the box outside. This is the box looks like. It is very lengthy, like nowadays we got OnePlus 8 and so. So all the key specifications are in the back side of the box itself. So this box gives us a feeling of a premium segment flagship phone. So we will see if the performance of this phone also relates to the flagship ones. So this is a nice ribbon like thing with refract lights. So this is the box package itself. It's very clean. So the key specifications, you can pause the video and have a look at it. I will cut the seal and open the box. As soon as we open the box, we got some huge pamphlets of user manuals and warranty guides, etc. I will also show you what we got inside too. So this is some work paperworks. So the phone directly, the phone itself, we'll keep it as a side just for now. A premium case which look as a leather case, but it is not a leather one, but it feels very grippy and nice. Then we got a Whoop charger, which is a fast charger rebranded as a Whoop charger by Oppo. So we also get a normal USB 2 type C USB cable. We also get a SIM ejector tool. Surprisingly, we also got a headphone. Nowadays no phone is giving headphones and all, I mean earphones. So let us peel the plastic outside the box, I mean phone, and have a look at it. The phone looks amazing. I am first time unboxing an Oppo phone. Previously I did many unboxing of many other brands such as Samsung, Redmi, Xiaomi, Lenovo, etc. But this is my first time unboxing an Oppo phone. So let us boot it first time. Let's see it has something juice or not. Guys, I have speed up the video for time saving purpose. We will select the language as usual. It asked us to connect to internet, so I just skipped it. So in this, you have to always turn off some of the diagnostic data, which will be very helpful for you for your privacy. I will always do that in each and every phone I unboxed, because Google will frequently send diagnostic data to each server, which is a mess. So getting things started, and let us have a look at settings. So this phone comes with a ColorOS 6, which is a very outdated version of ColorOS, because nowadays Realme phones are coming with ColorOS 7, which is a very great cons of this phone, I would say. Other than that, the hardware department, it has done very well. So as you can see, the about phone specifications like ColorOS 6, Android. And also I want to tell you that this runs in Android 9. You can see in its. Setting fingerprint, I will show you how to set fingerprint and how reliable it is. This is the real test. As you can see, it is very quick. So I will show you the available storage out of the box. I didn't install any application. So we have 224 GB usable, which is a very, very great thing, I would say. I will give a brief of a sound and video quality test. You guys watch it and make a judgment. This is a 4K video, guys. I downscaled it into 1080p. It will automatically do that in YouTube. So you can view the experience top to bottom, end to end display, and the color reproduction is also very great. The one thing I noted here is the brightness is a little bit downside. Other than that, the color reproduction is as always great because of AMOLED. So I will share you the basic camera samples I have took here. As you can see, the flower, it has detected as an subject and it has maintained well white balance here. Even the color of this flower are near to real, because nowadays Samsung will just boost the color to the top amount and it will look attractive, but in the production side it won't capable. This is the flower, a group of flowers, so I just bokeh others. So as you can see, these are all very minute things to see in naked eyes. So this is a zoomed out picture and hence the clarity is well. This is a animal portrait. It has maintained its subject very well. Yeah, the bokeh part done very great here. This is a 48 megapixel of super MP. So you can view the trees and grass, everything is fine. Even here, this is also a 48 MP picture. You can see the clear cut of this. So the main question is it worth in 2020 or not? Considering the price, nowadays we got M51, Realme 7 and Realme 7a. There are many segments in Redmi and other phones. Why you can choose this phone in 2020, is it capable or not? My clear-cut answer is yes. For whom? Means those who are worried about storage and looking for a greater feature like pop-up camera and in-display fingerprint. The only cons of this was ColorOS 6, but the great news is ColorOS 7 is arriving. You have to touch the top right eye corner button so that you will see a complete update video of this phone. Thank you. If you have any queries and suggestions, please comment down below. If you like my work, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.